Theodore Lambert Wesley, Superintendent of the State of Virginia. We are the 28th Episcopal District. Our diocese is the Honorable Bishop Robert A. Baker. If you've been looking for love in all the wrong places, always remember that Virginia's for lovers. We love Jesus, and we love you too.
Because we are region one!
Praise the Lord, ICEA members and friends. I am Sister Deidre Preston, Superintendent of the West Virginia and East Tennessee Council. Our diocesan is Bishop Samuel R. Moore. If you are down in the valley, come to the mountains of West Virginia and East Tennessee, because we are Region 1.
Because we are number one.
Cheryl Dansby, Director of Region 2, which is comprised of the Canada, Connecticut District, D.C., Delaware, Maryland District, New Jersey State, New York State, Northeast District, and Pennsylvania State Councils. And just as our song says, Region 2 is on the move for Jesus. We recently wrapped up our first ever virtual regional conference. Here's a sampling of our services and seminars, and we invite you to visit our Facebook and YouTube pages to view the full videos. Enjoy!
Yes, you are Lord! You are my life and my salvation!
Verses 41 and verse 10. And it reads as thus: Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with thy right hand of my righteousness. And the word of
while
the Lord.
While you're going through, stable your mind. While you're going through, get some soundness to your mind. I want you to know that again and again, the Bible teaches and affirms that God.
Verse 17 and 18, and Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. Sisters, this is sad. After all he said and after all he did, they did not see, they did not know, they could not understand the marks of Messiahship was walking up and down the city. They couldn't see that the marks of Messiahship was on full display before them. But with Peter's unwavering answer, that thou art the Christ, thou art the Christ, be my fire. Shall I be my boast? Ezekiel said, he's the wheel in the middle of the wheel. Daniel said, he's a lion tamer.
Of the adversary, but what good is it if it's only in the four walls? It's supposed to affect change in the world. But that's why he gave me the Holy Ghost.
We have three African American men sitting here now. Why? Because we had wisdom and sense not to go out and act foolish.
So you're saying that the African American men that are being slaughtered, they had George Floyd had no sense?
No, but you have to use wisdom.
So was he not using wisdom? He was asking them, I'm not doing anything. The car, they pulled him out and murdered him in front of America.
Look, I feel like it's already a struggle with our own selves in church. As Christian, as believer, it's a struggle already. So that's what we need to focus on. And God will do the rest.
That's right.
That's how I feel. It's already
we
a struggle as it is.
You love thinking not strange concerning the fiery trials which are to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice. This is your reasonable service as a saint of God.
Be holy, for I am holy.
Say that.
We're working this holiness thing. Sister Summer, do we have another? Is there another...
okay? If you're not growing, then something is wrong. You should not be spiritually stagnant. We should be growing in many ways. And as we grow spiritually, we should learn and adopt a good spiritual balance that will support our character, our good character, our good character. The things that I have learned through life, calling on God, that was not a good character trait. Afraid of praying. When we had all...
Let's see where we're going today. No, be ready so that you can establish a platform where they know that when they do show up, they will be taught the word of God. Amen. All right. So we talked about that. We're going to be looking to this morning. All right. So we talked about the word of God, excuse me, being taught. Secondly, or thirdly, have a powerful prayer ministry. Growth strategy. Amen. If you're going to grow, if your ministry is going to grow, you need to have some way where you can pray. We talked about that earlier about personal maturity. Now I'm talking about it as a corporate strategy. Amen. Whether it be your Sunday school, you need to have prayer. Pre-service prayer, prayer walk, prayer meeting, all-night prayer, online prayer. You need to pray just to pray.
Praise the Lord, everybody. My name is Elder Lawrence Morganfield III, and I am the Regional Director for Region 3 of the ICEA and the PAW. And we're here to represent Region 3 for our shout out to the regions. We thank God for being included in this opportunity to present. We may be third on the list of regions, but we feel like we're number one. God has blessed us. God has protected us. God has kept us. And we are all in his safety. We're all healthy and with the desire to continue on in Jesus' name. We represent the love for having Christian education. And we have decided over here in Region 3, we're not letting a coronavirus or any other kind of virus prevent us from being able to present Christian education to our region and to the nations. So we are glad to be here in the number one more time. We're so thankful that God is keeping us and showing his hand in our lives. But I'm not on this team by myself. This is a team, and we are a family over here in Region 3. So what I'm going to do is share with you who some of my family members are. I'm going to start with the Evangelist Charlotte Townsend in the Midwestern District Council.
Amen. Hello. Shout out from the Midwestern District Council. I'm Evangelist Charlotte Townsend, where I'm the state superintendent, and the M in Midwestern District stands for Mighty. We're the Mighty Midwestern District Council, where Bishop Larry O. Jones is our diocesan. We're here, and Missouri is known as the Show Me State, so we came to show up and show out. Now I'll turn you over to the hands of our friends in the Heart American of Churches, Evangelist Donna Jefferson.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
And on behalf of our diocesan, Bishop Mark C. Talbert, amen, and our director, Suffolk Bishop Daniel Chavis, Jr., and the entire Heart of America Council of Churches, we greet you in the matchless name of Jesus. Now on today, as we praise God and we're going forth with God's promises, me, myself, Elder Faye Anderson, and Deacon Larry Anderson, we are going to give you a shout out from the Heart of America Council of Churches. We are
HACC,
teaching God's word to all who have an ear to hear. We are
HACC,
continually steadfast in the apostolic doctrine. We are
HACC,
building up the kingdom for such a time as this. We are
HACC.
We are praising God and teaching his word during this virtual season. And we are yet teaching God's word. We are having fun in God's word. We want you all to just know we are on the road. Amen. For HACC, we welcome all of you. Amen.
And I'm yay for HACC.
We happy people. We're going to turn it over to the Minnesota, Wisconsin, Dakota, Deacon Derek Palmer.
Thank you very much, Sister Jefferson. Praise the Lord, saints. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I am Deacon Derek Palmer, chairman for the Christian Education Department for the MWDDC. That is the Minnesota, Wisconsin, South Dakota, North Dakota, where our own Bishop Richard D. Howell is the diocesan. We truly blessed, we truly is grateful to be amongst of you that's gonna be here. And I just wanna say that the theme of this ICE, this virtual conference, is God's promise to perform. And that is definitely what the MWDDC is gonna do. We're gonna promise to perform. At this time, we're gonna turn the rest of this to our own evangelist, Boltzart. Let's receive her.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Greater Lord. Tri-State Council is in the house. That is GTSC. We encompass the states of Wyoming, Iowa, and Nebraska because we win. Amen. Under the leadership of the Honorable Bishop Lance R. Foster, we are a part of Team Jesus, hallelujah. And what time is it? It's time for Christian education. We love Christian education in the Greater Tri-State Council. And we love that you are all here to learn more how to be better teachers and better students in Christian education. We thank you, we love you, we praise God for every one of you. Region 3 is the best region ever!
Yes, Region 3!
All right.
Amen.
I'm just driving to the grocery store. All these crazy drivers are just berserk. They are getting on my last nerve.
I know how you feel, Evangelist Winfrey. If I stay in this house any longer, I'm gonna go crazy.
I feel you, sister, because I'm on the computer all day long. Zoom for work, Zoom for church, Zoom for Bible study, and Zoom for Sunday school. Too much Zoom.
And I'm serving the Lord with all my might. Why am I going through? Seems like my enemies are taking aim at me. And guess what? They're winning.
I feel for all of you. I feel the same thing. I'm sick of the pandemic. I'm sick of hearing about Corona. Who's sick? Who's got symptoms? And customer service is awful.
Yes.
Mm. Oh, I feel you in the church. I'm so tired of this. I'm ready to get my praise on. And how can I get a praise on with this ridiculous mask on my face?
Help me, Lord Jesus. I'm exhausted and I don't know what to do.
And I just lost my faith. Don't know what to do.
Yes. I'm just struggling too, man. I feel like just tossing in the towel sometimes, just getting on my nerves.
Hold on. We cannot complain. For God is our shepherd, and we're standing on his word. Our general, District Elder Ford, has called this meeting, and we will not complain. We will.
Amen.
We will praise God in the midst of it all.
Attention!
Sir!
Yes, sir!
Soldiers, you're part of an elite squad.
Yes.
The army of the living God.
Yes.
I know many of you are discouraged, stressed, and fearful during this pandemic. But God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind.
Yes,
hallelujah. Yes. Hold on, soldiers.
Hold on.
God promises. We in Jesus' army.
Yes.
Region 4, are you ready to report to duty?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Roll call. Mississippi and Western Tennessee, present your weapon.
Sister Marilyn Burns reporting for duty, sir. We are guarded with the line of truth, sir.
Arkansas, present your weapon.
sir. Yes, sir. Brother Blevins' report says order with the breastplate of righteousness.
Alabama, present your weapon.
Sir, yes, sir. Sister Chrissy Christian reporting with the feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
Peace.
Texas, present your weapon.
Sir, yes, sir. Deacon Aaron reporting from Texas with the shield of faith, ready for duty.
Yes.
Oklahoma, present your weapon.
Sir, yes, sir. Oklahoma reporting with the helmet of salvation, ready for duty, sir.
Yes. Louisiana, present your weapon.
Sir, yes, sir. Lady Rogers reporting with the sword of the spirit.
Yes,
hallelujah. Soldiers, region 4, are you ready?
Sir, yes, sir.
God is still God in this pandemic.
Your God.
God is healing.
In the pandemic.
God is delivering.
In the pandemic.
God is speaking.
In the pandemic.
God is perfecting.
In the
God is saving.
In the pandemic.
And God wants his church back.
In the pandemic. Hallelujah.
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 Yes,
Lord.
You know what this means, don't you?
Yes.
This means war.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Region 4 in my soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. The pandemic is every day, but I'm watching while I pray. Even in my mask, I won't turn back, y'all, because this means war. This means war. Well, you can't have my family. You can't have my increase.
Oh, no.
You can't have my breakthrough. You can't. Well, I plead the blood. Well, region 4.
Yeah!
Oh, ICEA, yeah. Reporting for duty.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Yes.
Together. Jesus is alive and is doing well in Region 5.
He is really doing well.
Let's do this, state leaders.
Region 5.
I'm Sister Clementine region King.
Five. Region 5.
Of Director. All right, state leaders.
Well, praise the Lord, everyone, and greetings from Region 5, and more precisely, the great state of Indiana. I am Elder Marcus Russell, the president of the Indiana Christian Education Department of the ABSA Indiana Council.
Praise the Lord. This is Sister Doris Vaughn, Illinois District Council.
The First Apostolic Council of Kentucky and Tennessee, Minister Janet Carter, Superintendent.
Hello, everyone. I am Evangelist Gladys Nelstein. I am the president of the Northern District Council Christian Education Association from the great state of Michigan.
I am Sister Rachel Robinson, the Ohio District Council Christian Education Superintendent.
Y'all ready? Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Lord, everybody, give greetings to the ICEA, International Christian Education Association of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the Lord. I am the regional director for Region 6A. I am Yolanda Renee Forrest. It's my pleasure to be before you to introduce to you those that make up Region 6. We have in the Pacific Northwest, Evangelist Robin Edmond. We have in Alaska Yukon, District Elder Lisa Rollison. And we have in California, Evangelist Barbara Fivco. And we bring you greetings from Region 6 on the beautiful West Coast. Hallelujah. I have some scriptures that I want to read in your hearing. And then you will be able to see a little of what's going on in our individual councils. In light of what's going on in the world, this pandemic that we're facing, and the new ways of teaching, the acronym that I'd like to use for us learning new techniques is New Experiences in Teaching. That acronym is NEXT. We're looking for the next. There is no more new normal. Hallelujah. The scripture reminds us in Romans 13 and 11, and that knowing the time that is now, it's high time for us to wake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. Hallelujah. Revelations 3, verses 2 and 3 also says, be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die. For I have not found thy works perfect before God. I would read more, but I just want to admonish us to look at our teaching methods, knowing that we need to do something just a little bit different.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. World's changed so very much what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up all teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. World won't get no better if we just let it be. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it just the way we do. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. They don't have so very long for the judgment day. So won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders, time to build a new land. I know we can do it if we all lend a hand. Only thing we have to do is put it in our mind. Surely things will work out. They do it every time. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it.
Thank you. trust him in the morning, trust him in the evening, trust him.
Grace and peace, ICEA. We greet you from Region 6B, home of the great states of Central California, Southern California, Hawaii, and the Mountain States Council, consisting of Arizona, New Mexico, and El Paso, Texas. Take a journey with me to the West from the Central California District Council, the epicenter of the Contenders of the Faith, home of the Azusa Street Mission and Revival, and the Oneness Apostolic Movement. The theme of this council is positioned as promoters of our return to the bloody truth, coming from Revelations 12, 7 through 12. Down to the Southern California District Council, where the weather is always right and the armed forces protect the Pacific. Their theme is expanding our borders for change. Lord, enlarge my territory. 1 Corinthians 4 and 10. Our region travels west to the Hawaii District Council, where we go to the mountaintop to pray and take our shoes off to walk through the waters for baptism and embrace the culture and worship expression of our Hawaiian brothers and sisters. And then our region travels east to the Mountain States Council, Arizona, New Mexico, and El Paso, Texas, from the mountaintop to the valleys, where the sun never seems to sleep. Teaching is rich, and we get that iconic message, the taste of communion. Their mission is holding high esteem for God, for the church, sensing the need for a life experience of God through growth, maturity, and opportunity to serve. Listen to a soundbite.
So to believe in the Son is the remedy to cause perishing to cease. He loved the world. He gave the world his Son because the world was perishing. Okay, let's go to 1 John 3:16.
Region 6B was honored to present in Sunday school in Cincinnati, Ohio, in our 2019 convention. Here's a soundbite to chew on as we bless you to continue in the strength of God.
We can open up this reunion with prayer, because I'm sure all of us by now have realized that we need God.
Amen. Right?
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
And it's in those experiences that we have that when we find out who God really is in our life, we don't identify with fear anymore. When fear comes, we dispel it. Like Sis said, we say, hold up. God has not given me the spirit of fear. When I'm walking through the desert and I feel like I'm not going to make it, when I'm walking through the valley and I don't feel like I'm going to make it, then I turn around and I say, wait a minute. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. I see beyond what's in my room.
Thank you for the opportunity to serve and to share the life-giving, life-renewing, life-sustaining gospel of Jesus Christ. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everyone, and greetings in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. My name is District Elder William Terry, and I serve as the Assistant Treasurer for the ICEA. On behalf of our President, Dr. Barbara Payne, our Treasurer, Dr. Robert Grant, and the entire ICEA staff. We pray that you are being blessed by the program presented during this, our 2020 ICEA Virtual Fall Conference. It is now time for our offering. We're asking everyone to sow a seed into the ministry of the ICEA. We are believing the Lord for a tremendous and inspiring virtual session, and it can be done with your help. This is a wonderful opportunity for each and everyone to participate in this virtual session by your giving. You can sow a seed into the ministry of the ICEA by going to the homepage of the Pentecostal Ascendance of the World website and clicking on the Give tab at the top right-hand side of the homepage. You can give by using Giveify, which can be accessed through the PAW website, or by using the downloaded app on your mobile device. Please remember to choose the ICEA from the listed donation categories. Giving can also be done through PayPal, which again can be accessed through the PAW website. And again, be sure to choose the ICEA from the optional donation categories. You can give your donation from either your personal PayPal account or by credit or debit card. Giving can be done using the Cash App, using the tag $PAW offering. Please be advised that if you use the Cash App method, it is very important that you specify ICEA in the memo section provided in the app. Once again, if you use the Cash App method for giving, please be sure to type in ICEA in the memo section. And finally, giving can be done by using text to give, by texting ICEA and the dollar amount to 28950. That's ICEA and your dollar amount to 28950. For example, if someone wanted to give $1,000, you would text ICEA 1000 to 28950. We thank you in advance for how the Lord is going to use you to help make sure that the ICEA can continue to spread the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in these trying times. And at this time, let us pray for our offertory. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you today for both those that are going to give and desire to give to the ICEA. We ask you, Lord, to richly bless the seeds that are going to be given, and that this offering be used for the upbuild of your kingdom. Father, we thank you and praise you today for this offering. In Jesus' name, amen. And once again, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you for your giving to the ICEA.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord one more time.
Praise the Lord.
Have you come to lift up the name of Jesus?
Hallelujah.
Come on, with the fruit of your lips, just begin to bless God. He is worthy. He is deserving. We give him our worship tonight. Hallelujah. Great and mighty is he. There is nobody like him. Amen. We bless his name. Hallelujah. To him, because he is worthy. He is so deserving of our worship. We were created for this purpose. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. See, I love you. sing this to him. Say, He's been my shelter, say my shelter, forever. In times of storm, Lord, you've been my shelter. Yes, you have,
forever.
And we say, give you all the glory. Bless your God right there. Hallelujah. We give you glory.
Welcome back. I hope that you enjoyed the praises and the worship that went forth by Kingdom Life's praise team. And now we're going to go into the cyber sanctuary as the man of God is going to preach into our life. We're going to be favored from a word from the Lord from Bishop Barrington Smith. And if you have never heard this amazing and anointed and dynamic man of God, listen, you're in for a treat. Let me tell you a little bit about this Jamaican native. This awesome man of God is pastoring one of the fastest growing and most thriving ministries in Toronto, Canada, Kingdom Life Ministries. This devoted pastor and father and teacher, leader, feeder, friend, this anointed man of God does it all. If you haven't heard him preach before, I'm telling you, I know I've said it before, but you're going to be in for a treat because he preaches with such distinction, such clarity, and such passion that you are destined to be blessed by his ministry. Listen, this great man of God will preach and teach into your life, so I want you to be as open as possible. But before we go to him, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to share this broadcast because sharing is caring. You never know who might need this message. All over the world, people may be viewing into this International Christian Education Association's virtual conference. Now listen, we want to be a blessing to him because Bishop Smith has traveled all over the world preaching and teaching the Word of God, and there are people that are following his ministry all over the world. He's traveled to the Caribbean, to Italy, to you name it, all over the world he's been preaching and teaching the Word of God through his messages and through the books that he's written. So now without further ado, let's go into our cyber sanctuary and hear from Bishop Barrington Smith as he delivers the Word of the Lord.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, because God is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I certainly greet you all in the precious and powerful name of Jesus Christ. Greetings to our presiding bishop, the Honorable Bishop Theodore Brooks, to our first assistant presiding bishop, Bishop Mark C. Tolbert, to our second assistant presiding bishop, Bishop Michael Hanna, to the entire bishop board, to our international ICEA president, Dr. Barbara Payne, to all the cabinet staff of the ICEA, to my wife, Minister Corrine Smith, to all God's precious children, I say praise the Lord and greetings in the powerful and the exalted name of Jesus. I'm just excited to be with you here in this virtual conference of the ICEA, just to share a word from the Lord. It is always good to hear what God is saying unto his people. And so we're going to the book of Acts, chapter number 1. And we're reading one verse of scripture. And today I'm reading verse 4. And the word of the Lord says, "And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me. I'll read that one more time. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me. Let us bow our heads for prayer. Father, in the precious and powerful name of Jesus, we give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. God, we thank you for this opportunity, Lord God, to speak a word unto your people. I pray, God, you'll open the ears, the hearts, and the minds of your people to receive this word. I pray, God, that you'll anoint me afresh so that as I deliver, oh God, to your people, hearts will be changed, souls will be encouraged, and, oh God, chains will be broken. Bless us now, we pray, in Jesus' name. And everybody, just give God a praise in your heart for the glory of God. Amen. I would like to bring, amen, a message from the subject on this afternoon. The promise is secure. The promise is secure. Sisters and brothers, can I just say this, opening this message, that God uses our unfortunate circumstances to propel us into his plan, because God wants to take us to a greater level or a greater spectrum of his glory. And he does this for our greater good ultimately. But in God orchestrating our circumstances, there are times when you and I feel like we are at the end of our rope. Sometimes all the possibilities that we have for our lives, they seem crushed. And the dreams that we've been hoping would come to pass, those dreams just seem to be on a layaway plan. Our hopes are handcuffed, and it seems sometimes our hands are tied. And even vision that we have for ourselves, we can't see them coming to pass. Sisters and brothers, life is really complicated, because there are many times when you and I feel like there is no hope for us. There are times when we feel as if there is no way forward. We're looking for a light, but at times it seems as if we are on a dark road and we can't seem to find our way out. And so we gotta have to rest back on the assurances of God. Rest back on the things that God has said in our lives. And I'm here this afternoon to let you know that God's promise is secure and God's promise is sure. Why? How do I know that? Because we're living in perilous times. Even in the time that we're living in, we are still trying to put our arms around this pandemic that has infiltrated the entire world. And in many countries, there's instability even in the political arena. And what seems to add insult to injury, what seems to amplify our pain, our misery, and our agony, is when the present state that we're in seems to be a permanent reality. What do you mean? I mean that when it seems as if you're spinning your wheels and you cannot get out of the current situation that we are in. Sisters and brothers, if we choose to be real, we would testify that at times you and I are at our wits' end, where our situation sometimes doesn't seem to be getting better. It seems to be getting worse. And everywhere you look sometimes, it seems as if life is hopeless. And many of us are barely hanging on to a thread of hope, ready sometimes to call it quits and just to throw in the white towel. And if you have ever lived long enough, you will testify that at times you want to give up physically, but not only physically, there are times you want to give up spiritually. And that is it, when we are ready to give up on God, that is when our life is almost over. Sisters and brothers, if you have never been there, you may get there, or some of us are there right now. And I want to encourage you that God's promise is not only everlasting, but God's promise is secure and God's promise is sure. That is why you and I have to keep on believing. That is why you and I have to keep on trusting. Because when our government doesn't have a way out, when your father, your mother, or even your spouse does not have a way out, I can tell you this with absolute surety that God has a way out, that God will always perform that what he has promised, that God's promise is always secure and sure. And sisters and brothers, most of us sometimes will get to the point where we want to give up. And we may get to the point where we say this is enough, because when trouble is attacking us from the left and the right, when trouble is coming our way, and every time we look, we have to deal with another situation, we could easily, and I have been there before, when I feel like I cannot do this anymore, when it seems like situations is getting out of control, and it seems as if our situations or our circumstances are irreparable. And we're thinking, if things get any worse than this, then we might as well exit this life that we're living in. And I don't know about you, but I still believe in the power of Almighty God. Thank you, Jesus. I still believe in the promises of God. And I still believe that in the midst of every situation, I believe that in spite of what I am going through, I believe that in spite of my troubles, my disappointments, my pain, and my anguish, I still believe that God's promise is unshakable. I still believe that God is in control of every day of my life. I still believe that God is sovereign. And that is why I really praise him unreservedly. That is why I bless him at all times. Because when I cannot trust in human help, I can look unto the hills from whence cometh my help. Because my God is in control. And I want to say to the ICEA conference on this afternoon that God is still in control. Even when your life is out of control, God is still in control. Even when the pandemic is out of control, God is still in control. When our government is out of control, you might as well praise him on that, because you know, amen, that it doesn't matter what you go through, then you're able to rest on the assurance that though he slay you, that you can trust him. That you can learn to lean, glory, and to depend upon God. And I feel the presence of God already. But can I take you to our text? In the book of Acts chapter number 1 and verse number 4. This was an instruction from Jesus himself to the disciples to wait for the promise. And so in verse number 4, the Bible tells us that being assembled together with them, he commanded them, that is Jesus, that they should not depart, amen, from Jerusalem, but they should wait for the promise of the Father, which said he, you have heard of me. In this instance, the promise that Jesus was talking about, the promise that they were supposed to wait for, was the promise of the Holy Ghost. That means God is telling them, you got to get into Jerusalem and you got to get yourself in position for what I'm about to download into your spirit. Now, the disciples didn't have time, amen, to wonder about when God was going to do it. God did not tell them it was going to be a week or a month or a year, because the timing of the fulfillment of the promise was not that important. They just got to be in preparation, which means they got to be in Jerusalem, and they got to be waiting for the promise. And so the problem with most of us is that we spend so much time wondering about the timing of the season that we miss out on ourselves and stop preparing for the season. So you and I should not worry about the timing of the fulfillment of the promises of God in our lives. We should know that if God says it, that settles it. We should know that the promise will be fulfilled. We should know that the promise is secure. We should know that the promise is sure. And so I encourage you and I to get ourselves in preparation mode, because it shall come to pass, because what God says must come to pass. I feel the presence of God in this place, and we got to understand that when we trust God, we don't have to look unto other people, but we can look unto Jesus. And the Bible declares that Jesus Christ, he is the same. He is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. What do you mean, Bishop? What are you talking about? Because the God of the Old Testament is the God of the New Testament, and he is the same God, amen, that was at Pentecost, is the same God that is in our lives today. And if God promised it, then guess what? You can go to the bank on that thing, because I know he will bring it to pass. And I'm going to spend a few more minutes just to tell you some stuff before I decide to close this out. But I need you to understand, my sisters and my brothers, that sometimes it seems that our promise is in jeopardy. The reason why it seems our promise is in jeopardy is because the timing is not in conjunction with our expectation. What are you talking about? I'm talking about when I expect something to happen and I'm not seeing it happen in my life. And so sometimes we can get frustrated. Sometimes we can get to the place where we want to throw in the towel. But because God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, because he is a God that change it not. And Malachi the prophet, he assured us in chapter number 3 and verse 6. And hear what the prophet Malachi said. He says, I am the Lord. He says, I change not. Which means everything God said, everything God declared over your life, he will bring it to pass. Somebody better clap your hands and give God a praise right where you are, because we know your God, he's a promise-keeping God. We know our God is a covenant-keeping God. And glory to God. I'm going to get Dylan to come in and help me, because every thought, every promise, everything God said before the foundations of the world, every promise he made before time began, every promise he made since time began, every promise he made, it must come to pass. Glory to God, because God, he is a God, he cannot lie. I said, God is a God, he will not lie. God is a God, he just cannot tell a lie. And if God's word is true, then my God is true. And if God is true, his word is true. Somebody better praise God upon that word, because there's nothing, glory, there's nothing about God's character. There is nothing about God's nature that should cause you, that should cause me to wonder.
will ever keep his word. I feel like praising him because I can rest assured that God will always keep his word. Sisters and brothers, if God could not back it up, then God would not speak it in the first place. And so now is the time not to look at the clock, but now is the time to do like what the psalmist said in Psalm 121. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Oh, glory to God. We got to learn. I said we got to learn. We got to learn how to look to God. We got to learn how to talk to God. We got to learn how to worship our God. We got to learn to take our eyes off the wind and put our eyes on the God of everything. Somebody praise him. Somebody glorify. Somebody magnify him. I feel happy just knowing that my God is a way maker. I feel happy just knowing that my God is a provider. I feel happy just knowing that my God is a sustainer. That's why I clap my hand. That's why I jump for joy. That's why I lift up my hand. Glory, huh? Glory. Glory, glory. I can't afford to get caught up. I can't afford to get consumed. I cannot afford to get enamored by what I see. I don't go by what I see, but I go by what I know. And I know that my God, he's a covenant keeping God. I know that my God, he will always. Glory, 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 glory. So if you cannot see it, it can still be done. If you can't sense it, it will still be done. You can rejoice on the assurance that you can trust God enough. You can trust God enough to believe him completely, because his promise is secure. His promise is secure. Somebody praise God, because every promise that is over your life, everything that God said about you, the devil can't block it, the devil can't stop it, the devil can't change it, the devil can't sabotage it, because there's more, amen, for you than your eyes can see. There's a substance for you hidden that is greater than even what you can perceive. You can't see it with your eyes, but you can perceive it in your spirit, because I know that my God is always opening doors that I don't even see. He's always making ways out of no ways. And in this conference, I want somebody to know that if your God is for you, nobody can be against you. Nobody can silence you. Nobody can shut you down. Nobody can keep you down, because God's promise is over my life. Back up, devil. Let me step in my victory. Back up, devil. Let me step in my anointing. Back up, devil. Let me step in my progress, because doors are open for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I said doors are opening for me. I said doors are opening for you. I said doors are opening beyond what you have. Hallelujah. I've got to get out of here. I've got to get out of here. But I feel the glory. I've got to get out of here. But I feel the power. I've got to get out of here. But I feel the victory. abundant promises. Can I tell you this? There are some promises that the devil don't like, that the devil would like to block, but the promise is secure. The devil can't touch it because God put a hedge around it. In Matthew 28 and verse 30, God says, "Lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." This is a promise of the presence of God. What do you say? What are you saying, Bishop? Your promise is presence. And when God's presence is with you, you are so secure. In Romans 10 and 13, the word of the Lord says, "Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Which means you and I have a promise of salvation. In Jeremiah 1 and 8, the prophet says, "Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord." It's a promise of deliverance. In John 14 and 27, he says, "My peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled," glory, "neither let it be afraid." That's a promise of peace. Let me give you a few more. Isaiah 40 and 31. "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength." It's a promise of strength. Isaiah 41 and 10. "Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness." That's a promise of security. In Philippians 4 and verse 19, hear what the gospel writer said. He said, "My God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." That's a promise of redemption, of provision. John 14, 3, "And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." It's a promise of heaven. And I got to really close here, huh? And I could go on and on and on about the promises. But you get the general idea this afternoon, huh? That God's promises are secure, huh? And God's promises are sure, huh? And so can I tell you this, huh? In my last 2 minutes, I need you, my sister, I need you, my brother, to believe God, with every ounce and fiber of your energy, I need you to believe God for everything he said about you. I need somebody that is in, that is hearing my voice, to start declaring the promises of God. God, you said that you will bless me. God, you said that you will keep me. God, you said that you supply my need. God, you said that you'll open doors. God, you said that no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. Start to declare the promise. And after you declare the promise, start to rejoice in the promise. Because you know that your God is going to come through for you. Start to rejoice in the promises of God. And you have to live in the promises of God. That is how we live. And the greatest promise that we could ever get is the promise of the Holy Ghost. I got it. I believe it. I receive it. I'll walk in it. Walk in the promise. I said, walk in the promise. Live in the promise. Dance in the promise. Shout in the promise. Praise God in the promise. Because the devil can't do you no harm. The devil can't block you. The devil can't sabotage you. I might just work it out of here. But before I go, can I say one more thing? That when God comes through for you, you shall give him praise. Because in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. Oh, come on, give me praise. Oh, come on, give me praise. I got to be out of here. Oh, come on, glorify him. I got to go. May God bless you. May God keep you. May God sustain you. May he shine his face upon you. May he give you peace. In Jesus' name. And everybody say yes. Because we know that God is for us. And as we go, I want to pray for everybody under the sound of my voice. Glory to God who have listened to this word to take it. He has promised you salvation. If you're not saved, it's time to repent of your sin. Come to God and he will give you peace and he will give you rest. All where you are right now, if you're in the living rooms, in your cars, in your kitchen, in your bedrooms, glory, glory, hallelujah, yes, hallelujah. Wherever you are, I want you to pray with me right now, because God is releasing fulfillment all over his people right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, help us to recognize and realize that your promise is sure, and that your promise is secure, and that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. But God, you'll always be with us even unto the end. I declare the fulfillment of your promise in the lives of your people. Every broken vessel will be restored. Every empty hearts will be filled. I speak to the entire organization of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. Oh, mighty God, that you'll fulfill that which you have spoken. Oh, God, into the life of our presiding bishop. Oh, God, that will recognize, God, that every word you spoke, mighty God, they will come to pass. I speak for the International Christian Education Association Department, Dr. Barbara Payne and all her workers, that, Lord God, you'll fulfill your promises in their lives. In her life, oh God, speak to the hearts of your people. We forever praise you. We forever give you the glory. And we forever give you thanks. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, may heaven bless you. And I trust that something from this message reached your heart. God bless you as we say amen and amen.
All right, saints and friends, that's going to do it for us here at the ICEA 2020 virtual conference. It has been a pleasure and an honor serving you these past 2 days. I am so excited and my heart is just so full with how God has blessed us during this conference. Listen, it doesn't have to stop here. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to continue to like and share the content that comes out of the ICEA. You can like and subscribe our page on YouTube as well as on Facebook. And definitely stay tuned to those pages because new content will be coming forth in the days to come. But before we close, let's go and hear a final word from our ICEA president in the person of Dr. Barbara Payne.
Wow, what a wonderful 2 days we have had. God has to bless us immensely. The panel, the sofa chair, the information on how to win souls and minister to them at the altar, the rally of all our regions, and last but not least, the awesome word of God spoken by our auxiliary director, Bishop Barrington Smith, and the Canadian praise team. God has enriched all of us. We are ready. We are revived. We are refreshed. We're ready to go forth and conquer more land for the Lord. Remember what I said earlier. We are going to be meeting once a month with the ICEA roundtable. I'm directing you again to go to the PAWICEA.org webpage. Put your comments, put your thoughts, put the things that you would like to present on that page so that we can do this together. Everybody is important. Everybody is valuable. I need you, and hopefully you need me, so we can continue to build God's ministry. Stay safe. Stay safe. Take care until we can meet again. Bye.